Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear participants, today's topic is self and time management. Good thing is I have made all these things in PowerPoint presentation. And good news is that you will be able to get the PDF version of this presentation. But bitter news is that you will have to give this presentation to other community members. Are you ready to accept this challenge?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay.
Yes.
This is about the self and time management, and we are in, living in Canada. And now I have been given to understand that there will be participation from the three countries, Bangladesh, आपने कैमन आचन इंडिया आप कैसे हैं एंड पाकिस्तान आप लोग क्या हाल है ओके व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज द प्रैक्टिकल प्रोसेस ऑफ द टाइम मैनेजमेंट नंबर टू लाइफ लाइन्स एंड व्हील्स एंड सर्टेन टर्म्स वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस पोस्ट कोविड सिचुएशन decluttering and withdrawal and not to do list self management and improvement becoming effective and achieving more determine priorities of life and focus find time to focus on the objectives of the life okay now the next is our main objective is that we should know ourselves man arafa nafsahu faqad arafa rabbahu whoever knows himself knows his lord now let me give me 1 minute the thinking analyzing planning action and review are the objective of this presentation that after this presentation you will be able to do these 5 things and the on the left side you can see the steps the first step is always difficult and time consuming and need more courage we will try that we will be able to take the first step the other thing we are going to eat on right side we want to have a work life balance and on left side whenever we used to go on beaches we used to make this type of balance we need to create a balance for ourselves in life now before proceeding let's think about ourselves what are we doing in life this is our picture and situation okay the work pile up pending work the things to do the computer the time and everything is put on the last moment I am using the word our okay not yours the other thing is ignore the person who is riding the cycle see what is problem with this person has no direction the arrows shows this person is overburdened this person is lacking the control it means he is overburdened he has no direction and he has no control think about ourselves are we involved in these things are we facing this situation I think most of us are facing this problem this slide shows we are working very hard for ourselves for our home for our family and for our tehreek but we are riding on this horse will be able to reach our destination or we are just wasting our time or we are working out number 3 being muslim throughout the world and wherever we are we have lot of resources and the utilization of resources are like this you can see the resources available there are more than 100 staircases over here We could use one staircase to reach the destination, but we are using so much. And the next situation is that we are expecting too much from the seed we have sowed for our future. We are expecting grapefruit, we are expecting mango, we are expecting banana, and we are expecting melons also. This is problem with all of us. Now, the other problem is the people who belong to Pakistan know that on the right side is Parvez Musharraf, the ex-president, and on left side, Zafrullah Jamali, the prime minister from Balochistan. The issue always had been the power sharing. See the president of Pakistan, how he is sharing his power with the prime minister of Pakistan. Can we apply this thing to our home? We call Sas Bahu. Can we apply this thing to our manager and employee? Can we apply in our tehreek with the Nazim or Zimedar with other people? I think we will have to realize this thing. Next thing is how our organizations are running. If our home is running like this, it will be a disaster. If our office is running like this thing, it will be a disaster. If our tehreek or community is running like this, it is a disaster. So we have to think about this. Okay, we can go this way. We can go this way, but we should be going like this way. But we are going to this thing. Normally I quote, whoever people know the Urdu, Re, Fe, Ye, Kaf. These are the four huruf letters of Urdu. The first word we make from this thing is Rafiq, Re, Fe, Ye, Kaf. The second is Fariq, party. If you are going together, you are Rafiq. Otherwise, you are Fariq, like this. Or then you are going to be Fakir. These three words are made from the four huruf. Now this is the situation. What we are, we can see our shakal, we can see our face in the mirror, what we are and in what condition we are. And we don't realize that what is our condition, what are our weaknesses. But we perceive ourselves like this. We are cat and we consider ourselves lion. We are working zero, but we say we are doing 100. And this is the problem for all of us, that we will be doing it today, we will be doing tomorrow, we will be doing next week, and we are suffering from the procrastination, which does not allow us to start any work. And we are also suffering from the perfection, which does not allow us to complete our work. Now, understanding the self and time management process. There are three types of time: committed time, our sleep, our job, etc. Maintenance time, we maintain ourselves like food and all these things. And control times, which may be 4 hours a day or 3 hours a day. So we will be focusing on how to manage our control time, because many other things are beyond our control. Now this is the process. Identify and assess ourselves. A. B. Determine objective of our life. Number three, set goals, lanes and wheels. Bring change. Number four, which is detailed. And number five is assess ourselves and manage and improve ourselves. Now coming on the point A. There are 4 points. Know yourself and document the diagnosis. For this, you will have to, and we will have to make a notebook or an electronic document for ourselves, either on Word or on Excel or any sheet. I would suggest sheets like Excel preferably. So we can do on the monthly basis, weekly basis, daily basis. Number two, analyze our plus points and minus points, our assets and liabilities, our strengths and weaknesses. Number three, review our internal and external matters, which are either controllable or non-controllable, and review our examine our habits and routines. These are the four points of this review process. Now come on the number B. Determine the objective of life. We all know what is our objective of life. This is Raza Ilahi. Itaat and ittiba. Okay. Think what the life is. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ is the objective. Determine it. What should be the impact of these objectives on our life? What are the expectations by adopting these objectives? This should be. Determine life goals keeping these objectives. This is very much important. This is a part of our process. Now coming on the C item, understanding the lanes and wheels of the life. Whenever you travel, journey, you travel on the lanes of the highway, and you are traveling on wheels, and you do the journey. On the right side is your goals. Now, what are the five lanes of our life? Number one is personal. My personal matters, my understanding, my habits, my thoughts, etc., etc. Number two is education and career. Number three, economic, job or business. Number four, family levels, our parents, our siblings, our own family, and social or society or community. These are the five lanes on where we travel in 24/7. Now, what are the wheels? The first wheel on the top is sense of responsibility. If everyone has a car over here, if you see the car, we normally consider there are four wheels, two front, two back. But there are two more wheels. One is the steering wheel and one is the wheel we keep as a spare wheel. Okay, keep that example in mind. The sense of responsibility is your steering wheel. You drive. And the character is the hidden thing which demonstrates when necessary. The front two wheels are attitude and habits. The back two wheels are skills and three T's. What are three T's? Technology, tools, and techniques. Now try to understand this grid. These are five lanes and six wheels. And I understand that if we want to manage our life and our time, we will have to focus on this grid and we have to do work according to this. My understanding is that in personal life and all other five lanes, the sense of responsibility is the most important thing. We can give 10 out of 10 numbers on this box. But in other areas, we can give come. If you make this grid for yourself and you analyze yourself on weekly basis, I understand that we will be able to improve ourselves a lot because this will show us the daily progress and weekly achievements. The gentleman, sense of responsibility, character, attitude, habits, skills, and three T's are the wheels, and the personal, education, family, economic, and social are the lanes. Now, this slide is for the business or economic thing, which I don't need to discuss it today, but I am sharing with you, and it will be available with you, so you will be able to work on this thing for your things, which we will discuss about the skills. Now, the number one thing in this process, C is we need to understand where our time goes. We have a 24 hours a day, multiply by 7, 168 hours. Try to account for this time for a period of 3 weeks. You will be able to see where you are spending of time is there. Like for your own house or your business, you make a budget and you say where your money is drained out. In this condition, you will be able and we will be able to know where our time goes and how to control it. Try to make this thing, our activities like this thing, and we will see this circle, everything is there. But we should be able to categorize this thing and prioritize this thing, and we should know what are our priorities, what are our time obligation, what are important and desirable activities, what are unimportant and not desirable activities, and time wasters. Now, ultimately, we will be able to come on this grid, which is called Eisenhower grid, or Stephen Covey has described it in quadrant shape. But in here, important, not important, urgent, not important, I will include one thing more, which will make it pentagon, that is our values, our religious values. This is more important. Now come on this thing, the red shows do it now, the green shows do it later, the third blue is showing delegate, avoid it. Now this is a separate topic or exercise which may be discussed separately, and you can refer my presentation on YouTube for further detail. But today we are not going to discuss these things. The life has to be disciplined like this. There are certain things not to do. There are certain things which are allowed and we have to do. And there are certain things for which we have to be cautious. We see the top picture. We plan, okay, we will be reaching our destination in 24 hours like this. But see the next picture downward. It shows, Araftu Rabbi bi fisqil azaim, I have found my Lord in the breaking of my intentions and my plans. Araftu Rabbi bi fisqil azaim, maine apne Rab ko apne iradon ke tootne mein paya hua hai. So now we plan and there are God's plan. So we have to do our work and then tawakkal it. But our work is necessary. We have to knock the door. That is our duty. Now there are three terms. One is the Pareto law. You put 20% effort but get 80% results. You are 20% customers, provide you are 80% business. And your 80% effort goes for the 20% result. So what we are going to do is we have to focus on the Pareto law, the 80% result oriented things. There are two other terms, is a prime time. Everyone has a 2 hour, 3 hours prime time during 24 hours. Try to find out that time. And everyone has an energy level. Some people get energy level in the evening time. Some people get the energy level in the early morning. To find your energy time and prime time. Okay, now the fourth and the longest one is bring change your life. Again, I will be requesting that please decide that you will be using either notebook like this and pen, or you use the electronic document, Word, Excel, anything which can be helpful for you. And you can name that document SMB, self-management book. Number one is set goals. Number two, make attitude and habits according to your goals. Goal has to be according to your objective. Goals have to be personal, education, economic, family and social. And make your attitude in accordance with your objectives to achieve those goals and try to build up your capacity and capability according to your goals and objectives. Then do the resource mobilization. Make a to-do list for weekly basis, monthly basis, or make a 5 years plan. But everything has to be done on Excel with the various gaps. But to-do list has to be done on daily basis. You remember that Nabi Akram Salam was in the field of Badr, war of Badr, and he was sketching something on the dust with his finger. The war planner, the Western war planner, says that the leader of Islam was making his war plan. After that, making to-do list, there is one list which is more important and which we don't do is, that is not to-do list. Because if we make the not to-do list, we will not many various time wasters in it. I'm not going to discuss time wasters because a 90 minutes presentation is there on YouTube on the time wasters. You can see that video. But for today's purpose, please try to make a not to-do list, which is important. Now we are talking about the bring change in life and we are documenting it. Review the thinking, bring change in our attitude, change the habits and bring with according to our objectives, check our abilities and make them according to our objectives, check our relationship with the people and decide on whom we are spending our time and on whom we are wasting our time. Spending time is different and wasting time is different. We have to do it accordingly. Check our engagement activities, work on our character and morality. We have to be trustworthy. People should rely on us and we should maintain our integrity. We will have to organize and consolidate ourselves. And we will have to review our activities and decide which activities are necessary, put in to-do list, which activities are unnecessary, time-wasting, put in not to-do list. Make and control anger and behavior and do not become a difficult person. Don't try to engage yourself in unnecessary discussion and tanqeed and mazak and humiliation. These are prohibited in our religion. Improve the habits to be more effective and review skills and improve them. Learn the technology, tools and techniques. Control the time wasters. You have to identify your time wasters, internal time wasters, external time wasters. And manage your procrastination and interruption. Do all work and activities according to objectives. Prioritize work. Do within the time frame, because work expands according to time available. Do it in a better way. Avoid clutter, unnecessary and extra items to be removed. And please give yourself some time daily, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Talk to yourself. Hasibu kabla an tuhasibu. Wazenu kabla an tuwazenu. Ke logo apne aap ka ehtisab kar lo kabla iske ke tumhara ehtisab kiya jaye. Accept the mistakes. Be respectful. Keep the self-esteem of people. Always give respect. Try to, if you are talking in Urdu, try to use the word aap. Follow the procedures and SOPs. I am trying to follow the procedures. I try to know what is the culture of this thing. So please, whenever you go somewhere else or you are giving dawah to other people, try to understand their culture. Do the right thing, the right way, at the right time. Do the right thing, in the right way, at the right time. This is more important. And number 4 of this slide, A place for everything and everything in its place. A place for everything and everything in its place. And three and four are more important for us in this environment. To-do list, personal planner, planning and scheduling, self-management book, I have already discussed. Now coming on the last part of this presentation or the process, act, progress and review. How we are going to act on these ideas and things. Number one, planning. Planning is thinking in advance what steps we are going to do is. Okay, if you fail to plan, you are planning to fail. And when you are doing planning, prioritize it, target them, schedule it. If you don't schedule, don't target, you will never be able to achieve those things. Try to build the team. Try to delegate it, because delegation will empower you to do other work. Implement the process of accountability and implement the process of regular review and follow-up. Review and follow-up. What is review? Review the ranking and prioritizing your goal. Do priority-based planning. Determine the withdrawal plan. We will have to withdraw from certain activities, from certain engagement, if you want to achieve our goals. Make a timetable. Use technology and devices. Everything is available over there. Free downloadable. Schedule the time and arrange the resources to accomplish our work. And there is arithmetic, not mathematics. Focus plus concentrate. Focus is the point. Concentrate is your mental attitude. Find the prime time. Have an energy level is equal to high performance. These are the 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 = 1111. Okay, not 4. In the fifth process, make a daily list based on weekly planner and adhere to it. Learn the teamwork skills to accomplish more. You remember in a jung, Nabi Akram Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was also lifting the stones to do the necessary work. Develop our team, train them, negotiate and delegate. Make the accountability standard for yourself and others, and have a reward system. If you don't have any reward system or recognition system, it will be difficult to sustain and survive more. The third item of this thing is be updated, bring new thinking and work style to accomplish more. Have a system of time recording. Have regular and frequent self-accountability and assessment system for yourself, for your family on the weekly basis, weekends to discuss the family matters, in your organization, in your Dawa work. Please don't try to this thing, because you have to realize that three fingers are coming on your side if you put one finger on the other side. So please avoid this thing. This is very difficult to work for Deen or Tahreek. Hold yourself accountable before you are held accountable. If you have made some mistakes, accept it. No issue. You will be regarded high. And today should be better than yesterday. This should be our plan. Now this process is complete. And now I am going to finish this presentation with a few slides. Now this is about teamwork. Everyone is contributing its own role by putting necessary block. Together, everyone achieve more. This is the TEAM. And please remember this thing. This is a chart. Manistava yomahu fahuwa magboon. He whose 2 days are equal in accomplishment is a sure loser. He whose 2 days are equal in accomplishment is a sure loser. If you are as good as you were yesterday, you will not be good for tomorrow. If you are as good as you were yesterday, you will not be good for tomorrow. The book written by Hashamut Talib on the for the Tarbiyah of the Ikna people. They are referring this thing as a hadith from the Dar al-Ilmi, but I have been advised by Jamiatul Rashid Karachi that this is the, not the hadith, but this is a dream of Hazrat Safiyan Sauri. The Nabi Akram Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him in his dream that Manistawa Yomahu Fahuwa Makbun. For us, this is important that Manistawa Yomahu Fahuwa Makbun. So try to make yourself accountable, make an Excel sheet, make a graph, make a this type of graph. And every Saturday or Sunday, preferably Sunday evening, please try to make yourself how you have gone during the last week. If you can do it daily basis for 1 month, 2 months, it is good. But at least we should be doing on the weekly basis. I remember in 1971 when Professor Ghulam Azam Shaheed was here in Karachi, in Nazmabad, he has advised us that we should be doing accountability on weekly basis. And I have also heard this thing from Maulana Sadruddin Sahib in Lahore. कि तुम हर वक्त इस बात का जायजा लेते रहो कि अल्लाह से कितने करीब हुए, शैतान से कितने दूर हुए, जन्नत से कितने करीब हुए, शैतान दोजख से कितने दूर हुए। हासिबू कबल अन तुहासिबू। एंड दिस इज वमन यत्तकिल्लाह यजअलहू मखरजन व यरज़ुकु मिन हैसु ला यहतसिब वमन यतवक्कल अल्लाह फहु हसबुहु। इफ वी आर फेयरिंग Almighty Allah, then He will provide us the opportunities and He will provide us provision from the unexpected way. And you can see this stone, this rock, and there is a plant emerging out of this thing. And many things will happen in our life if we fear Almighty Allah. Now I will be sharing this presentation to you, inshallah. In a day or two, because I will be needing some improvements, and there is acknowledgement of this presentation. I'm thankful for all of you. I don't know how much time we have spent. I think 40 minutes completed. Okay, Alhamdulillah, we completed in 40 minutes. Okay. So I stop here, and then speaker and things are with you. Zahid bhai, you take the mic and you take the control of the presentation, please.
Yes, JazakAllah khair, brother Rashid Juma. It was a very comprehensive, very detailed presentation, and I will repeat myself again that we are very lucky, we are very blessed that Allah gave us. Brother Bashir Juma in Canada, and we are able to get the benefit out of his knowledge, his skills, and the experience. So, JazakAllah khair. As a Central Tarbiyah Committee, we are very pleased to continue with the connection with the Brother Bashir Juma. We have added as him as our regular Murabbi, inshallah, and I think it will be a very good addition and excellent addition into the Murabbeen of the Canada, inshallah. So your presentation, Brother Bashir Juma, is one of the brothers said, and I will just echo it, is the PhD level presentation for the time management. And I think one of every one of us is going to spend the time, print these slides, and I think they can start to work on their own personal and life management. And I'm pretty sure that every one of us will get the benefit, because this one is this presentation is not the presenting in the world universities or where there is no deen or madhab involved. Alhamdulillah, this presentation is based on the Quran and Sunnah, and is everything related to our objectives and our target, what we have been told from the since our beginning of our life, and we are setting our goal to go into the Jannah. And I think this presentation is going to help us a lot to manage and utilize our time in the most efficient and effective way. So JazakAllah khair for your time. And your presentation tells your introduction. So I was right in the beginning that I don't need to introduce you. Alhamdulillah, your presentation is telling your introduction. So Jazakallah khair. I do have a few questions here, and I will just read. I will start the one question from myself, and then we'll go from the second one. I remember the every year I make the resolution, and the one resolution is the I do have a to-do list every day, but the most important thing, how can I make say no to people? Because I have a very bad habit. I cannot say no to anyone. If my wife asks something, I say yes. My friend called me, I say yes. Then the Amir called me and I say yes. Then I ended up in the so many tasks at the same time. Then I would be in the puzzle, how do I justice? How do I give a time
and spread my time? So
most of the time what happened, I just split myself everywhere. So what is the take on point for me? Maybe we, probably other brothers also in my shoes. Can somebody mute your mic, please? Imran bhai, can you take care of this? And so what is the one point you can give us a piece of advice to handle this situation? Jazakallah.
The best way is whenever a person make you disturbed, make him your advisor. Okay, note down his request and say, okay, let's discuss when we can do it. I can do it, but it will take 2 weeks to do it. Okay. So then it will be able to understand them that every request cannot be done it. As far as your wife and your family is concerned, I understand we need to have a family schedule, and normally it should be placed on your refrigerator. Okay, these are the weekly plan and these are the things we will be put as a sticker. Okay, and we can do it accordingly. But you should make your family members and your team members at your companions, not your opposite persons. But that is approach to be changed. You can note it down, you can agree for deferment, and you can agree them to withdraw from that thing. But it all depends on your Hikmat-e-Amli strategy.
Okay. One question from one of the brother. It says, great speech, inspiring, lots of slides. He said, for the novice like me, what is the starting point for me as a grade one student? Let's say, what three things I should do this week on this action plan of the time management? If you give out three things for it.
You make an Excel sheet, okay, from left to right, the 7 days of a week, and from top to bottom, see your strength. Kullun insanun ma'adan. Human beings are like mines, gold mines, silver mines, copper mines, okay? But we are like gold mines and silver mines. And we have to extract ourselves. We have to shine the glass like stars. Our duty is that man arafa nafsahu faqad arafa rabbahu. We should know and understand ourselves, what are our strengths. The problem is that we spend too much time on other things in which we don't meet ourselves, we don't understand ourselves. So please note down your strengths. You are a great man. Note down your weaknesses. Okay? Try to improve your strength, try to decrease your weaknesses. Okay, then on the after this thing, write your time wasters. Where you are wasting your time? Facebook, WhatsApp, so and so. Control it. If you are engaged in something which are not advisable or prohibited, control it. Make a dua. Do salat hajat for improvement yourself. Before going to work, do 2 rakat for Salat Hajat and ask Almighty Allah to guide you, help you, and to make your day better than yesterday. But it all depends on your determination. Objective, Raza Ilahi, goals, five lines, and how you are going to do is, these are the six wheels, how you are the part. What is Raza Ilahi? Where is your lanes? And the how is your six wheels? These are important. Next.
Jazakallah khair. One question is, assalamu alaikum, question on the slide where a tree with different fruits is shown. How this go along with our concept of deen as a complete way of life, covering all aspects of life? Udkhulu fi silmi kaffa.
You are talking about the grid of the five lanes and six wheels?
I think it's talking about the slides where the fruits, different fruits are shown.
Okay.
Jaisa beech aap boenge aisa.
Political. Are you talking about the fruit wali slide, Chaudhary Shujaat?
I don't know which one. Brother Sharif is there?
Yeah, I'm yes. here. I was on
yes,
mute.
Please go ahead. Can you explain your
the
question, please?
Concept like you cannot go into multiple directions. I think that's the concept of the slide where the tree was shown. If you could go, please, to that slide. We can understand better. So I took it that way that don't put your efforts on multiple things because you're not going to achieve a single thing. So that's true. But when we talk about Ikhamat-e-Deen, we talk about politics, we talk about the family life, we talk about the social aspects and economic aspects of it, everything. So we want all the fruits in result of our whatever we do. So that's what we are trying.
I think, Brother Sharif, Jazakallah Khair, I think you're talking about the prioritizing things in our organization. So, Brother Bashir Jumar, you got the...
Which slide we are talking about?
I think it was the one when you sow the seed and you get the different kind of fruits. And
now,
then,
now, the problem is, if we are connecting that thing with the deen, so that slide was not meant for that objective. That slide was, if you are doing a medical practice, or if you are doing something else and you are expecting that I will be able to do, get the fruit from one seed, from the various fruits, that is our misconception about the outcome. Your outcome has to be in relation to your input. That is important. The concept of izzat, rizzat, and barkat is a qualitative aspect. I am talking about the quantitative aspect. If you are putting the seed of mango, you should expect mango, not grapes. That was the understanding, and that was the thing for the persons who are wasting their time and procrastinating and expecting more. That was the objective of that slide. I did not mean that that slide is for doing the work for dawah and getting fruit. Yes, if you are taking that thing, you are doing the dawah work and you are doing the spreading the good deeds, then results are more than expectation, because your input is one and your result is 10. If you write one, this is your effort, but Allah, for him, everything is nothing. It will be zero for you. So this one will become 10 for you, and another zero will make it 100, another 100. If you are talking about this thing, then I appreciate your observation. Thank you.
Jazakallah khair.
Jazakallah.
Sharif bhai, you got the answer?
Ji, Jazakallah.
Okay, Jazakallah khair. One question, Brother Bashir Juma, is some of the brothers, I would say the most of the brothers, especially when it comes to MGAs and members, they keep asking how much time is enough time to give to our organization. Most of the time we recruit the people in the committee and we promise them, okay, you have to do 2 hours per week. Somebody says 6 hours per week and 10 hours a week, we expecting from you. And then we recruit the person, brothers, into the committee, and then we go from there. So is any a time, a quantitatively time to need to give to organization necessary, or you have other advice for the brothers to take on today?
Okay, Brother Bashir. Let me give first emotional reply, okay? The emotional reply is that it is just like ishq or love. And when you have ishq or love, you are engaged and involved 24/7. You are engaged in 1,440 minutes. Now, the dawa and organization work is the form of your main objective. And your main objective is Raza-i Ilahi, itaat, ittiba, and the following, the SOPs set for us in whatever form these have been given. Please give this, keep in mind this thing, everything which we are doing is for the Raza-i Ilahi. So you are spending 1,440 minutes a day, 24/7. Okay. Now it is up to you that how you are going to manage your time to do the real dawa work. Because most of our work is done like that wooden horse, which we have seen in one slide, which does not reach the destination. So most of us are spending time like riding that wooden horse. My suggestion is, please make your directions, complement each other, support each other, create the momentum in your organization and relationship with your organization, that each one is complementing and supplementing each other to progress further. In that case, 2 hours is not necessary. Maybe you considered 8 hours are also not sufficient. So it is up to you. It is your understanding. But at least in the initial stages, we should start the allocation of work at least 2 hours for which we are committed. As you are committed for payment of your credit card on monthly basis, you are committed for this thing. This is the card recording somewhere else. This is recording from here, Kiram and Katibin. Okay. We are talking about the Kiram and Katibin. We can talk also the virtual things and website things. These are all important. But we must give some time and we should bring motivation in our tahreek. If we don't bring motivation and we are working like this, okay, and confronting each other and becoming a fariq with each other, having a different and diversified thoughts and not coming on this thing, we will not be reaching on any destination. So please try to understand and find out the things which will motivate us. Then this question will be addressed automatically, because 10 minutes, 20 minutes or 2 hours will not be important. The more important thing is your engagement and energy level. The more motivation will be there, the more energy will be there, inshallah.
JazakAllah khair. One question is, you have worked, mashallah, in the national level and the international level as well, with work with the very, very more well-reputed organization, multinational. Usually in organization, we have a typical day for the employee to what to do in a day. Do you have any format made by you for the worker of the movement? So what should be the day look like for them? If you do, would you please like to share? And if you do not, would you be able to make for us, then we can share with our team?
Brother, I have done this type of things. These are available on my book, Highway to Success, and Time Management for Muslims, and my personal planner. Okay, and inshallah, I will share those things. There is a sheet of 2 pages. One page shows the planner, other page shows the the namaz timing or etc. And 25 items here, 25 items here, and from Monday to Sunday. So you can put it this thing. But it is available on my mobile. I will share with you people. But there are certain better things available on websites. I appreciate that you asked me because you consider me as a Tehreek person, and I will try to improve that. But whatever available with me is, I will share today or day after, or today or tomorrow. And if need be, in the next discussion, I will make a new sheet for you. It's not issue, inshallah.
But Jee,
because I always say buildings are built with bricks, and for bricks you have to have a frame with you in which you mix the cement and other material to make it brick. So the frame, the schedule or chart is necessary. I agree with that thing. I will share with you, inshallah.
Jazakallah khair. It's not necessary in a day or two, because may Allah give you the long
ready,
life and the
it
health.
It is ready.
Inshallah.
Yeah. I have to just forward it to you.
Inshallah. Jazakallah khair. There are so many brothers have praised for your presentation. I just wanted to convey to you while you are here and all team members. Everybody said this presentation was... And I think most of us is stunned by the presentation as well. So that's why I was expecting more questions, but I think they still try to go through the presentation, and they are just trying to comprehend themselves what to ask, because there are many, many things in there from day and night schedule. So I'm hoping the people are going to bring more questions in the next presentation, inshallah, when we have it. The second people asking, the brothers asking that, am I going to share this presentation? Yes. So number one, this presentation is recorded, as we all motivational speeches are recorded in the past. Inshallah, we'll share. Brother Imran Rahman is the administrator of this group. So inshallah, he will make this and he will share with the Zoom recording as soon as possible. Brother Bashir Juma is going to share his presentation, and I will forward it to all brothers in this group and any other chapter groups. And number three, inshallah, Brother Bashir Juma, people asking your contact number. If you allow us, so I can share your contact number to those brothers who have any personal question to you, if they wanted to. Is that okay? Or you can give me answer after, okay. Not necessary now.
My email address is given on my presentation. And if you want to share my WhatsApp number, you can do it, okay?
Okay. Jazakallah khair. So I think we have done our time, and the last 4 minutes are left. Brother Bashir Juma, if you wanted to summarize in the one or two after the question and answers, then we will just announce a few things after 1 or 2 minutes. I'll give it to you.
Am I right that everyone can understand Urdu or Hindi?
I think majority, I would say 90-95% understand.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me finish with the example.
Yeah, please.
One person was reading his book for next day interview. And this book was more than 300 pages. Uska bachcha usko baar baar aakar tang kar raha tha. Usne apne bachche ko chup karne ke liye toffiyan, biscuit, sab cheeze di. लेकिन बच्चा खामोश नहीं हुआ. इसने बच्चे को मारना मुनासिब इसलिए नहीं समझा कि कहीं बद्दुआ न लग जाए. पाकिस्तान का और इंडिया का और बांग्लादेश का माहौल कह रहा हूँ. तो उसने ये किया कि हमारे घरों में अखबारात होते हैं कि जिसको हम चाहते हैं कि छुट्टी के दिन पढ़ेंगे, और छुट्टी का दिन कभी आता नहीं है. तो उसने अखबार निकाला. उस अखबार में उसको जो है एक फुल पेज का वर्ल्ड मैप मिल गया. उसने बिछाया और बच्चे को बिठाया के सामने, और मुल्कों के नाम बताए, दरियाओं के नाम बताए, समंदरों के नाम बताए, पहाड़ों के नाम बताए. और फिर उस अखबार को उठाकर इसने टुकड़े किए और बच्चे के हाथ में दिए, और 10 रुपीज दिए कि जाओ बाजार से इस कोष्टे प्ले आओ, बराबर की convenience shop से और इसको चिपका कर ले आओ. He thought it will take 2 or 3 hours and he will be able to complete most of the book. But the son came within 10 or 15 minutes and saying that Abu duniya ka naksha theek ho gaya, Abu duniya ka naksha ban gaya. So he asked his son, to, what happened? Sir, Papa, I have made it. कहा बेटा तुमने कैसे बनाया? तो उसने कहा था अब्बा जान आप नक्शे को ऐसे ही रखो जैसे आपने रखा था. कहा जब आपने नक्शा उठाया तो मैंने नक्शे के पीछे देखा कि आदमी की कद्दे आदम तस्वीर फुल साइज तस्वीर बनी हुई थी. बस मैंने आदमी की उस तस्वीर को ठीक कर लिया, दुनिया का नक्शा खुद ब खुद ठीक हो गया. नाउ मेरी आप लोगों से रिक्वेस्ट ये है कि आज की प्रेजेंटेशन का मकसद जो है अपने आप को ठीक करना है, तो फिर आपको इंशाल्लाह इज्जत भी मिलेगी, लिज्जत भी मिलेगी, बरकत भी मिलेगी, हालात भी आपके लिए साजगार हो जाएंगे और हवाओं के रुख भी जो है आपको आपकी डेस्टिनेशन पे पहुंचाने का सबब और मददगार बनेंगे. और वमन यत्तकिल्लाह यजअल लहू मखरजन वयरज़ुकुहु मिन हैथु ला यहतसिब, कि जो शख्स अल्लाह से डरता है अल्लाह उसे ऐसे रास्ते से रिस्क पहुँचाता है जहाँ इसका गुमान भी नहीं होता. और रिस्क की डेफिनेशन डॉलर्स नहीं है, रिस्क की डेफिनेशन घर का सुकून भी है, बीवी बच्चों की इताअत भी है, काम में मज़ा भी है, दुनिया की बेहतरी है, दीन की बेहतरी है, आखिरत की बेहतरी है. बस रब्बना आतेना फिद दुनिया हसनत व फिल आखिरत हसनत व क़िना अज़ाबन नार अमा अलैना इल्ला अल बलाग.
JazakAllah khair, brother Bashir. I think you summarized very well everything in the one sentence. So JazakAllah khair. Inshallah, I will share brother Bashir Juma's YouTube link and also some other presentation is shared by brother Bashir Juma to me. And inshallah, I think I thank you to brother Bashir Juma to sharing me few clips and the videos for 40 minutes. I will inshallah share with the group as well. So with this wording, I would like to say thank you, personal thank you for myself and the IKNA and the Tarbiyah Committee, Brother Bashir Juma, for giving your precious time. May Allah bless you with the knowledge and also give a barakah in your knowledge, in your experience, in your life, and protect you from any calamity and the pandemic, and also increase the enhance and give a barakah in your family and your family life. JazakAllah khair. I'm very pleased to announce in the last that, and I'm very excited to announce that our next speaker, it's already been set on August 1st, inshallah. I think first Sunday of the August. We are getting, inshallah, honorable, respected brother, Saadatullah Husseini. He is the Amir of the Jamaat Islami Hind. Inshallah, he's going to speak with the IKNA members on August motivation speech. So I will request all brothers to make sure to mark your calendar, and not only mark your calendar, also talk in your chapters in the neighbor nets and bring as many as brothers, because we do have a capacity of 500. So I can accommodate up to 500 brothers and sisters if they wanted to join. Even if you wanted to bring your youth, please bring them as well. So inshallah, it will be very excited about this program, inshallah. JazakAllah khair. I will request to brother Bashir Juma to make a dua at the end, and inshallah we will end up our program. JazakAllah khair.
Alhamdulillah, Ali Zati Azim Sifati Sami Simati Shan. La ilaha illallah Mannan Badu Samawati Ram. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammadin bi adadi man salla wa sam. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد بعدد من قاد وقام. اللهم يسر ولا تعسر واتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح يا اللهم لا سهل الا ما جعلته سهلا وانت تجعل الحزن اذا شئت سهلا. اللهم اني اعوذ بك من الهم والكسل والجبن والبخل والجهل. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم آت نفوس تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا مولانا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه وسلم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
آمين. جزاك الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. السلام عليكم brother and stay safe.
وعليكم السلام. جزاك الله. Thank you very much.